All right, I will continue with problem number 60 and 7 from Calculus Early Transcendental by Stuart, edition 7e. Once again, my name is Dolphy Gilpin, for those who, of you who are new to my class. Problem number 6 to 7, chapter 5, page 440. And it says here, the integral of x into root of x minus 1 dx, and the limits given here are 0 and 1. Okay, so we're going to find a solution for the integral x into the square root of x minus 1 dx. Once again, to simplify matter, we make a substitution here and take the most convenient substitution. Let's put u to be equal to x minus 1. If u is equal to x minus 1, it follows that du is equal to dx, and that x is equal to u plus 1. Alright, u equals x minus 1, therefore now the integral becomes now the integral of x is equal to u plus 1, and x minus 1 becomes u to the root of x minus 1 becomes u to the r, which is the square root of u. So that the new problem now is the integral of u plus 1 times root u du, because dx is equal to du. So that's equal to, if we simplify here, root 2 times u would be u to the 3 over 2. That is u to the 1 times u to the half. You add exponent, u to the 3 over 2, and plus root u, which is u to the half. Write it in this form sometimes, and that's du. And that's equal now to the integral of u to the 3 over 2 will be u to the 3 over 2 plus 1, which is u to the 5 over 2. U to the 5 over 2, and we divide by that, so that will be 2 over 5. And this is now plus u to the half plus 1 over half plus 1. That will be 2 thirds u to the 3 over 2. That's plus c, but because limits are given, the c's will drop out. So we have 2/5 u to the 5 over 2 plus 2/3 u to the 3 over 2. All right, and that's between 0 and 1. Okay, we could find the new limits here by substituting. We could find the new limits here by substituting now. If x is equal to 1, if x equals 1, then u is equal to 0 from this equation. So that the new limits will become now, the upper one would be u equals 0. And if x is equal to 0, which is the lower limit, if x equals 0, u is equal to, we put 0 here, u equal minus 1. So the new limit here is between 0 and minus 1. So we have 2/5. Of course, we could make the resubstitution and keep the original limits. We get it back in the form of x. All right, but you can go either method, you will get the same answer. So we have now 2/5 of u to the 5 over 2 plus 2/3 u to the 3 over 2 between minus 1 and 0. Now if u is equal to 0, then this term is equal to 0, and this term is equal to 0. So it leaves us with u equals minus 1. We have minus 1 to the 5 upon 2 minus 5 by 2/5, of course, minus now 2/3 minus 1 to the 3 upon 2. You could do the arithmetic for that, and I think that would be 16 upon 50. You could see it because anything to the 1 is 1, and this is also 1. It takes the minus if it's the index is uneven, it takes the minus sign. So that really comes out to be 2/5 minus 2/3, and 15 would have been the LCM. 5 over 15 was 2, 3 times 2 is 6, and 5 over 15 was 3, 3. 5 over 15 is 3, 3 times 2 is 6. And 3 to 15 goes 5. 5 to 10. So 10 minus minus 10 plus 6 would be 16 upon 5. 15.